Hi guys. Have you ever been in a place where you've had plenty of sleep, maybe too much, but you still feel exhausted? Like that soul tired type of a feeling? Maybe there's too much going on in life right now and you just need a break. That's what this class is for. So this is gonna be a yin class. We're not even gonna stand up. So grab two blankets, roll them up like so, if you can. Even a couple of pillows would work. That would work just fine. Maybe even a cushion off of the couch might work. Just something that's maybe about 6 inches tall. Two blankets works perfect. Pause me, grab it, come back. Once you come back, if this is at night, light some candles, burn some incense, maybe even grab a glass of tea. Make an event of it. It'll help. All right. Once you're set up, find your comfortable seat. Start to pull that full attention inward. Forget about life. Forget about responsibilities. Forget about everything. For this next hour, it's all about you. All about renewing that spirit, right? Recharging the soul. Let the shoulders soften down away from the ears. Shoulder blades slide down the back. Imagine a little thread connected to the crown of your head, lifting you up just a little bit taller than usual. Now soften through the ribcage, soften through the chest cavity, and let that diaphragm drop. Let those inhales start to fill that whole chest space, that whole belly space. Each breath a little bit deeper, a little bit slower than the one before. Now on your next inhale, see yourself counting on a chalkboard. When it's time to exhale, do the same but in reverse. Stretching those breaths out as long as you can. Good. Now taking the biggest, deepest breath of the day, filling that whole chest space, that whole belly space. Then with a big sigh, exhale completely. Then inhale the arms out and up. Bringing the palms to touch. Exhaling down through heart center. Inhaling out and up. Bringing the palms to touch. Exhaling down through heart center. Good. Last time. Inhaling out and up. This time when the palms come to touch, interlace those fingers. Exhale, tip to the right side. Inhaling center. Exhaling left. Inhaling center, dropping that right arm down, exhale, leaning to the right, take your time. Actively reaching those fingers away from you, feeling that stretch in the left side body. Back to center. Exhaling left. Take your time. Inhaling center. exhale, lower those arms down. Now bringing the left hand to the right knee, the right hand behind. Inhaling tall. Exhale, twisting belly first. Bend the ribs. Bend the shoulders. And finally the gaze. Thinking about growing taller with each inhale. Maybe twisting just a little bit deeper with each exhale. And one more big inhale here. Exhale, returning that gaze to center, followed by the body. Right hand, left knee, left hand behind. Inhaling tall. Exhale, twisting belly first. Bend the ribs. Bend the shoulder. And finally the gaze. Growing taller with each inhale, twisting just a little bit deeper with each exhale. And one more big inhale here. Exhale, returning that gaze to center, followed by the rest of the body. Now coming to a tabletop, rolling over the knees if that works for you, otherwise kick those feet out to the side, that's fine too. Then once you get into your tabletop, take a big inhale. Then exhale, set back into your child's pose. Now here's the first time we're going to use our blankets if you want. You can go for your regular child's pose or set your blankets down and have your child's pose on top of those blankets. It's awesome. Think about letting every joint in your body settle. Think about letting as many of your muscles relax as possible. Just melt in. These poses are long. They can be 4 minutes, 6 minutes, even 8 minutes. Low and slow. It's meant to give you time to contemplate, time to clear your mind, time to release anything that you're holding, you know, in your body, the emotions that you're holding in your body. So get yourself comfortable and let yourself settle in. Don't think about what's coming next. Just be right now in child's pose. Supported, comfortable. Turn your head at will, too. If you have your forehead down, that's great. If you're going from cheek to cheek, that's awesome, too. And you don't have to wait for a particular time or anything. Just turn your head at will. Towards each other, maybe even the toes touching. And then if it feels okay on your knees, you can bring your feet apart like a frog. And then just relax down. You might need more blankets under you here, depending on your flexibility. Set yourself up, whatever's comfortable. slowly. Bring your big toes to touch behind you. Press yourself back and pull your knees together so that you're back in child's pose, one knee at a time. Gently pressing yourself up. Let your hips fall off to the side. Let your left leg come back. So you're bringing your right hip up to your blanket, or your right thigh up to your blanket. Your right foot is on your left knee, and your left foot is just kind of tucked in behind you. Inhale, sit up tall. Exhale, twist yourself towards your blanket, and then walk yourself down. Now your gaze can be to the right. If that's not very comfortable on your neck, your gaze can be to the left. Either way is just fine. The point here is for it to feel renewing, rejuvenating for you. So whatever feels best. Thank you. walk yourself up. Coming into Baddha Konasana, so just bringing the bottoms of the feet together. Move your blankets behind you. Hold them tight so that they come right up against your sacrum or low back. Now let yourself just melt forward in our vinyasa class, our regular yoga classes. We make it a point to come from the hips here and, you know, and pull down that way. But here we're just going to melt forward. Just soften. moving slowly and gently. Roll yourself off to one side, doesn't matter which. Then gently press yourself back up to a seat. Good. Our next pose is legs up, Upa Vista Konasana. You can do it straight on the ground, or you can use your blankets if you want to. And what we're gonna do is just lie back. Pull your blankets or a block under your hips, or even straight on the floor. You can use your hands to prop yourself up a little bit. And just relax. Find that point where your feet stay up effortlessly. Can I see Upa Vista Konasana? Viparita card. Don't worry about any kind of breath control here. If you feel like sighing, do it. Let it out. Now put a bend in the knees. Pull out your blanket or block, or move your hands, put your hands under there. Squeeze your knees. Take a big inhale. Exhale, let those knees fall off to the right side. Keep that left shoulder down if you can. Slowly, gently, maybe just one knee at a time, bring those knees back to center. Give yourself a good squeeze. Big inhale. Exhale, let those knees drop off to the left, keeping that right shoulder down if you can. Gently bringing those knees back to center, maybe one at a time. Give those knees a squeeze.
Big inhale. Exhale, extend into Shavasana. Take a moment. Get yourself perfectly comfortable, maybe tucking under the shoulder blade. Maybe tucking the chin, laying that long neck down. Get really comfortable. Now relaxing the forehead. Relaxing the eyebrows. All of those little muscles around the eyes, relax them at the throat. Softening the cheeks, letting them melt down towards the ears. Relaxing the jaw. Letting the tongue fall away from the roof of the mouth. With each exhale, feeling your body pressing heavier and heavier into your mat, feeling that profound sense of grounding. With each exhale, falling deeper and deeper into relaxation. Now in your mind's eye, I want you to see yourself standing on a trail in a forest. Filtered sunlight coming through the canopy above. Some leaves mulching the ground beneath your feet. Down the trail, you can see a staircase made of stone, very natural. You walk towards that staircase, and as you come to the top, you can't see the bottom. But you're so drawn in by the beauty of the staircase itself that you decide to walk down. With your bare feet, feeling the cool stone with each step as you walk down the staircase. With that smell of damp moss in the air. Slowly descending the staircase. Finally coming to the bottom, you see a manicured lawn surrounded by dense forest. It doesn't seem to belong there, but it's beautiful. Across the lawn, you see something that looks familiar. It's not quite in view, and you decide to walk over and investigate. As your foot touches the cool, damp grass, that sensation of profound grounding goes through your entire body. You continue to walk across the lawn. As you arrive at the other side, you realize it's your favorite place. It's that place where you can relax completely, where you feel perfectly safe, perfectly comfortable, perfectly loved. Your perfect space, and you sit down or lie down, making yourself perfectly comfortable in the way that only you know how. Now for these next few moments, just relax. yourself coming back into your body, maybe feeling the breeze on your skin, hearing the sounds inside this room. Maybe wiggling your fingers, maybe wiggling your toes. Maybe reaching your arms overhead for a big full body stretch. When you're ready, rolling onto whichever side is the most comfortable for you, using your arm as a pillow, savor these last few moments of perfect relaxation. Take a big inhale with me. Through the mouth with a sigh, exhale. One more, big inhale. Exhale. One more, big inhale. Exhale. And inhale the arms out and up. Bringing the palms to touch. Exhaling down through heart center. Inhaling out, hands up. See yourself grabbing a handful of divine energy. Exhale, pull it down to heart center. Feel that warmth. See the glow. Last time. Inhaling the arms out, hands up. Bringing the palms to touch. Exhaling down to the third eye for the mind. Exhaling down to heart center for the body and spirit. Namaste. Thank you for being here. If you took this class just because Yin is awesome and you wanted to and it sounded fun and you did it, awesome. I hope you feel fantastic and relaxed. And if you took this because there's something great going on in your life right now, I hope it helps. Little things like this really do help to nurture the soul when we need it. So, to all of you, namaste.